This is a real-time feed. This is real data. I want to preface this by saying that a lot of the areas that are blurred over here are not blurred in your system. I am simply just blurring them because these are real people. So these are real people that just connected. For example, this person connected 2 seconds ago. This person 3 seconds, 5 seconds, 6 seconds, 8 seconds. I'm just looking for a nice profile with a picture I can show you. But all of these profiles have data. They have, in this case, we have email, time spent, and device MAC address and device type. We have the location they connected to, their upload and download, how much this person just connected, so they're just getting started. They've visited 2 times, and they've been there for 23 minutes total. So as you can see, this is like pretty cool. This is 20 seconds ago already at this point. It's like, you know, happening so fast. This person comes, visits the location. You not only get their data, but you can also map and track this throughout the entire experience. So this is what our clients see. This is real. This is happening, I believe, somewhere in South America. This is the campaign that's running. Again, it's blurred for privacy reasons. It's a MikroTik device. They have 4 people online right now. And if I look at the contacts over time, I can see that there are 18 people that have connected here in the last 7 days. These people just got started. So your clients can always go in here and see the automations that are running. They can see the devices that are set up. They can see a timeline of who's connecting here in real time. You know, so at this specific location, you can see just a couple people every day, or, you know, 2 days ago, 4 days ago. That's a little bit slower traffic. Let me show you guys one with a little bit higher traffic. Let me show you a client that, you know, really has a lot of traction. And, you know, we actually have a ton that have a lot of big traffic data. So I'm just going to pull up some over here and show you guys kind of what's happening. And if you guys have any questions specific about how any of this works, or why you'd want to collect all this data, or what's happening. So here, 37 people online right now. And let me just see what the time. Yeah, last 30 days. So 7,000 people in the last 30 days. Have connected to this network. It is running Meraki over here. You have your individual reports about how many people over the last 30 days have connected. They're clearly focused on SMS. So they've collected 7,400 SMS numbers in 30 days. Okay, that's pretty awesome. You're not collecting emails there, so this wouldn't matter much. But you're doing male versus female. You can see how many people are connecting. You can also see presence data. For example, if you want to see in the last, look, these guys have only been running also, I should say, it's 7,000 only since September 13th, and today is September 27th. So that's insane. That's 2 weeks. And you can see over here in the last 2 weeks what the trends are. So clearly this is a place that is busier on the Friday and Saturday. This is collecting, let me just clarify what this is. This is showing the number of connected users in this day, in this week time frame, I should mention. Number of passerbys and visitors that are connecting over here. The daily guest activity. And these are not people that are connecting. These are people who are just walking by with their phones in their pocket. So this is what presence analytics is. This is the ability to show you what the busiest time of day or day of week is. That's really awesome. Here's another location that's collecting some data. You have people collecting just for connecting just for a few minutes, but they're getting, there's 73 people online right now, 6,000 guests. You know, 350 gigs of bandwidth, all being served up from this one gateway. And you can also see reports over here, who's connecting. You can see the extended, the hour of the day. I can break this down and filter this at any time, in the last 7 days. Or I can actually look at the actual day. Like I can look at the day and the time frame. I can break this out by range. Sorry, I got to do it by hourly on daily. So I can now break down to see, like, you know, this is the day, and I can see, oh, by 3 p.m., we had 100 people connect, or at 3 p.m., we had 536 guest visitors. And then after that, I think this is the time there now at this location. It's a few hours ahead in Africa. And this is happening right now. So you had all these visits happening. Clearly, the busiest time is 2, 3 p.m. We'll see what 4 p.m. brings. But this is all real data, guys. This is all coming in, streaming in real time. 28 seconds ago, 35 seconds ago, these people are connecting. And you can see all about them. In this case, we also have this user's gender. We have their exact date of birth, the month, date, and year. We have their device type. We have all the details about the location that they connected to. And we also have the automation history, whether or not they received their messages. You can see over here, MailChimp comes back with different reasons why certain things go through. For example, we can see this one as well and see for every user, we can also see like there's success. You can see all the email events that have happened, whether this person clicked it or not, that would be shown there. So you can get really granular here with the kind of data that you're collecting. And again, you're not collecting data and you're not selling Wi-Fi. Sorry, you're not selling Wi-Fi. You are collecting data for your clients. And here's another example using OpenMesh. You can see here in the reports, these people are just in the last 7 days, even 1,500 people in the last 7 days. You can see the busiest time of the day is over here. I believe this is overseas as well. So this is in my dashboard. It's middle of the night for me. But in their case, it would actually be 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. In that part of the world.